Welcome back here to Seaway 3, game number 4 of 4. It is the Seneca Sting, the OCAA runner-up, beg your pardon, against the VIU Mariners, who won the PacWest Championship. Excuse me, as a win really taking over my voice. So it is VIU against Seneca. Seneca, who lost to Humber College in the OCAA Finals, and VIU took out Douglas 5-1 in the PacWest title game to book their tickets here to Champlain-Saint-Lambert for this game here, as we will have a very unique battle with these two teams going at it today. Seneca 10-0, VIU 8-2-2, and what should be a very fascinating game, compelling matchup with these two teams going at it this year. We talk about a high-scoring attack of Seneca, which had 50 goals and won against the entire season, against a VIU team that had 6 clean sheets, and they won by an average of 2.5 goals per game. So we'll see how this plays out early on in this matchup between Seneca and VIU. So the coin toss now being done. The last piece of the puzzle to keep the gold medal bracket complete. VIU or Seneca? We could have a OCAA RSEQ gold medal bracket formation here, unless VIU decides to ruin plans, which they like to do, and get themselves to that conversation of being in that gold medal frame. As you can see now, the VIU as VIU now get takes their team photo here. And now the last of the coin tosses here from Seaway 3, as the temperature now dropping towards single digits here from Seaway, as it gets very cold at the evening portion of the game here, as it is 5:30 p.m. local time. We welcome those watching this game from Nanaimo, B.C., home of the Mariners. And what will be some history between these two teams here, which we'll get into throughout the course of this game, of what could be played out with these two teams. VIU in their home whites with whites trim, numeral navy, and white socks. And for Seneca Sting in their blacks, top, bottom, and shorts, and socks as well, white numerals going forward here. So OCAA versus the Pac West. One of these teams will keep their gold medal hopes alive. The other will have to go through the bronze medal route. And most certainly none of these teams want to be the early or late morning game. They'd rather be in this spot tomorrow night against Hunsick. So VIU against Seneca here from Seaway 3. As we get ready for kickoff here, the fourth game of the day, as the men's are well underway at Langara College in lovely Vancouver, B.C., where I'm sure the weather is a lot more comfortable than it is right now here from the banks off the St. Lawrence, as we're south of the downtown region. For those who are not very familiar with this area of Montreal, we are in Saint-Lambert, Quebec, which is in the south shore of the area, about 15-minute drive from here to the city center of the area of Montreal. And now the last words of encouragement from the Seneca and VIU team benches. 3 down, 1 more to go. The last piece of the puzzle for the gold medal equation about to be completed in the next 2 hours here from Seaway. What does Seneca and VIU have in store for us today? A game that could definitely bring edge, twist in the plot here. Hunsick smashed Mount St. Vincent 6-1. Champlain defeated Red Deer 1-0. And Humber took out St. Boniface 3-0. Seneca will go left to right. VIU right to left in this opening half of play. Seneca may thought were the powerhouse team, but they got stung by the Humber Hawks. And now we get ready for this game here. We talk about VIU. They met Seneca in 2019, in which VIU won 3-2. So there's no question that right now for Seneca, they'd like to exact revenge on that game. Nine players from that 2019 roster is on this VIU roster, including Shane Batty, Kara Dunlop, and Mel Osborne. And we're underway here from Seaway 3, and is Seneca on the pitch on the attack? And they're underway here. Narduzzi's pass to the far side. Coming out to the left wing, and now away they go. The Sting trying to work their way through. The through ball, well read by Gulo, and this will be played back out into the VIU territory. Gulo being chased down to the near side it goes, and this will be a throw-in coming up here for the Sting. And this will be taken in this time by Hoyt. And this will go to the last third of the pitch. Played through. Dillabaugh. Here is Pania. And back to the corridor goes. And over it is to Iaveri. And this will be played back out. Iaveri will play back into the circle. This goes back and forth here between the two teams. And played into the near side it goes. Here is Yamamoto. Talking about Yamamoto, started nine games, third-year player from Tokyo, Japan. In fact, this VIU roster has a lot of players from the Japan area, and this is going to go out to the middle part of the territory. Here's VIU's first 10. That's poked away as Machida couldn't get that cleanly. Played to the near side it goes. Here is Dillabaugh. Yamamoto. On the left foot, near post, and this is going to be taken rather easily by the keeper for Seneca in Raven Edwards. Down all, and this will take a couple of bounces off the ground, and now look for options to work with. Launched up in the air, and this will be taking a one hop. Played through, once again, headed back through. Here comes Seneca the other way. Could this be the chance coming in? And unfortunately for Alfred, could not get the right trajectory. She had 12 goals, 3 assists for the Sting during the regular season of the OCAA year and could not get her feet untangled on that play. Play through. Here it comes Pania. Back to the corridor goes, and Seneca will look to re-rack this position again once more. Pania. The through ball does not come in, and that's going to be cleared away. Mike Creed, who had 2 goals, started 10 games in their first year. We'll go back over to keeper, and it'll come back over to Kara Dunlop. Started 9 games, fourth-year player from Nanaimo, BC, a local at VIU. One of the Rolls Royces on this roster when it comes to the Centurion leadership and dominance that she brings onto the pitch. And here she is looking to spray one ball down the near side, and she does. Racing down there is Dillabaugh, as she's in a 1v1 race going foot for foot with Hoyt, and she gets that ball back. Dillabaugh down the 1v1, eyeball to eyeball, nutmegs Hoyt, whistle the play, and this will go against VIU and Seneca ball. VIU's only title came in 1993 as Malaspina College, in which they hosted and defeated Sherbrooke 3-2. For the Seneca Sting, this is the fourth trip to the Nationals. They finished in sixth in 1995, bronze medal 2014, and did not play the fifth place game due to weather. And so for them, looking to reestablish themselves as a national power in a very tight OCAA, and here they are as the runner-up this past season. Alfred. That goes off the back of Famale, and this will be played back out to the Seneca side of the pitch. And now here are the VIU as they'll re-rack this possession, trying to get themselves moving forward. And that is Melanie Osborne, started 8 games, fourth-year player on this roster. Through ball, that's taken away. And back over it goes. And here is Shanice Alfred. Once a big part of that is Maya Creed, who had 2 goals for the Mariners. Yamamoto, third-year player. Kinley, started 9 games, 1 goal, 1 assist. Creed, looking to Probroy through. Long ball deflected. Still alive. Into the feet of Dillabaugh goes. And that will be cleared away by Seneca. Still with his Dillabaugh in the final third. VIU showing a little bit more ingenuity so far in the early going in the first five. Seneca a little bit on their heels trying to adapt to the sea levels of this game. And it will be Yamamoto who will have the throw-in on the near side. And this will go over the head of Dillabaugh, and this will be a throw-in again for Seneca. So the Sting looking to get themselves established. That goes over Alfred's head and played back over to Kyra Dunlop. Creed into the circle. Good, intricate passing by the Mariners. One touch at best, and they will retain possession. And back it comes to Creed once more. To the far side it goes to Kate Reynolds. Reynolds, this year one goal in 8 games, fifth-year player. So playing her last games, depending on how far they go, for VIU. And this will be a throw-in again for Seneca against VIU. That takes a ricochet. Loose ball. Sting can't get to it. That's going to go right by Mazarenko. And now a race for it as the Sting are trying to push the heels of Yamamoto. And this will be played back to no man's land. And a giveaway here for Seneca. Could they punish the Mariners on this play? As Street couldn't get that ball cleanly. Panea. Lovely turn. Shot, and the first easy save coming in as Street did not get much fizz on that. And this will be back over to the VIU Mariners. That's deflected through. Alfred. To the left wing it comes. Four options of black uniforms up ahead for Seneca. Alfred now in a race and winning that is Kara Dunlop. And that will go out for an easy throw-in option for the Sting as Dunlop took the option one route to minimize any potential glitches along the way. Long ball up ahead. It goes by a plethora of players. Still into the Seneca Sting's hands, and this will be a slow roller out of play. We talk about shots. Seneca was number one in the OCAA at 274. VIU at 158 for the season. Seneca, they were plush of goals, 50 for the year. And for VIU, only 21. So you have to wonder for VIU if they're going to might take a little bit more caution element here and make sure they don't give too much space to the Sting. That ball's launched up ahead. Here is Machida trying to win that over, and this will roll out of play for a goal kick for Seneca as we're through 9 minutes in this first half of action. Talk about the Seneca goal scoring again. We talk about how plush they are. 9 players at 2-plus goals, including Alfred and Lamacchia with 21 in total. So the partnership of those two was phenomenal for the Sting this year. Ivery's pass. That will get through. And away come the Sting the other way. Here they come down the right flank. And this is kept in and saved along the lines by Dillabaugh. And over it comes to Yamamoto, who will now look for options. So she will go with the short route instead. Over to Kara Dunlop. Creed. Creed and Dunlop, the central partnership of the back four, the spine of the defense for this Mariner roster. That's forced up ahead, played back down by Machida. And Machida can get the return pass, and this will be going back the other way for the Sting. And that takes a ricochet out of play, and this will be a throw-in for the Seneca Sting. So right now, this game, a bit of a slow burn, early going right now in the first stages of this matchup. And that's pushed back up forward. Here comes the Sting, Street with it. To the corridor she comes. intercepted, well read this time by Yamamoto. And that's taken away in the heels of the move from VIU. And now open space to work with. And here comes Street. Diagonal pass. And this will go right by. And Olmes giving away. And that's going to be a clash of bodies. Referee says, get up. And this will not be a foul as Lamacchia was looking for the foul. And there was a caught in two minds moment there for VIU on the miscommunication coming in from Reynolds along with the keeper in Osborne, who both slowed up. And that enabled Lamacchia to come in. And no foul, the referee says. And play on, we go. Thorne for VIU on the far side in front of their team bench. Fired up ahead. Taken away, back out, and this will be a throw-in again for Reynolds. So part two of this opportunity for her coming up. She'll go through the lower route and played back out to the midfield stripe. Here's the first touch coming in for Courtney Ingram, who had 2 goals, 1 assist this year for the Mariners. Yamamoto. First touch too heavy, and this will be played out over to Kinley, that is. Dunlap. Headed back down. Machida couldn't get that cleanly. And that's taken away this time by Seneca. And lovely move coming through from Hoyt. And here comes the touch and finding its way through on the ball with Street. And that's taken away by Dunlap, who cleans up any mistakes that could be evident on the counter. Iveri. Kinley. Femeli. Street. To the final third it goes. Dunlop in a race as, again, using her strength to let that ball go out of play for a throw-in for the Mariners here from Seaway 3 as we're through 13 minutes of play here in this first half of action. Yamamoto. Dilaba. And that is punted away. And here come the Mariners. This could be a 3-on-3 here if they work the numbers properly. To the right side it comes. And now working the flood of white uniforms forward. And right there is Iveri to take that away. And that's taken down through. Here is Street. Diagonal pass. Try to get that through. And Dunlop right there for the Mariners to push that back out into the circle. Play through, and Yamamoto right there, and she will go back to her keeper in Osborne. Dunlop. Comes over to Reynolds. Reynolds and Dunlop, the two keepers along with Creed. And that will go over everyone's heads, and this will be out of play for what should be a throw-in for the Seneca Sting. So early going, slow burn to this game here. Both teams trying to feel themselves out. That's been the case so far for all the teams here, not knowing each other's styles of play so far. But this, out of the four, might be the most mouth-watering matchup in terms of the equality that is on both sides here. Kinley. And this given over to Ingram. Ingram can't get that. And back out to the stripe it comes. Over it, looped over. Yamamoto will get to it once more, being pressured on the near side. And Dilaba out there in support. And now we're starting to see the press from the Sting, trying to close down the gaps and play it into the open space it goes. This could be a giveaway. Shot, far post, and oh my. And Alfred. She is a poacher of goals, and her postal code is in the 18-yard box, and she almost got the first one off a mistake from VIU. And Kara Dunlap might have to pay more of a babysitter notice against the foot of Alfred, who has been phenomenal for the Seneca roster. Here's Dunlop. Creed. Creed again. We'll loop one up ahead. That's taken away by the back four of Seneca. And over comes to Alfred. Here's Alfred. Trying to create space from the circle. Back out to Iveri. Near side it comes. And Yamamoto right there to push that up ahead to the near side. And here's Dillabaugh. She's got plenty of space to work with. Oceans to work with. Looking for the options they have. She goes back in. Here's a one touch inside the 18. Down to Dillabaugh on the near side. And takes a ricochet. Iveri right there. And she's being pressured and pressed. And this will be out of play. So this will be a throw-in for VIU. Yamamoto will have the throw-in on the near side as we're a quarter of an hour through in this first half. 0-0 between VIU and Seneca. Dunlop. Going back to Creed. Switch of play to the far side. Played over two. Mazarenko dancing her way through. Open space. That created a little bit of action for VIU against the Seneca last line of defense. And now played back on the counter. Here comes the Sting the other way. They got 4-on-3 now if they work the numbers in their favor on the speed angle. And here they come. Down to the left side they go. Final throw of the yard. And this will be out of play for a goal kick. And you can see the speed of VIU closing down any distance with them, stride for stride against the Seneca Sting. Dillabaugh. Popped up in the air. Yamamoto. Dillabaugh again. Dunlop. Creed. Trying to spray a ball forward, perhaps. She'll go with a short route instead, and she'll find Kinley instead. Dunlop once more. Yamamoto, watch closely as now Seneca trying to close down the gaps here with Street on her. Creed will bring it up pitch. Long ball through, headed away by Iveri. Street loses the focus on that ball and a slip and play. Dillabaugh recovers and now here come the Mariners. And that is delivered through and that's taken away by Seneca on the last line of defense. Yamamoto can't get that cleanly, and now played over once more to Ingram. And that ball had too much depth on that play, and now we'll go out for a throw in here for the Sting. And that ball not handled cleanly by Pena. As they'll do another retake of that. Dunlop. It's taken away by Kinley, by Ingram, that is. Space to work with. Kinley. Back over to Ingram. Yamamoto. Working the triangle ever so seamlessly is the VIU Mariners trying to get themselves a one touch and off their feet. Away they go. As they want to make Seneca chase them on possession. And they've opened up the Sting on that sequence. Going to the far side it comes. Give and go. Taken away. And still with it are the Mariners. And played through once more. Kinley. Yamamoto. And this will be out of play for a throw-in. Dillabaugh, lovely move. That ball takes the deflection off of the ankles of Rebecca Lee, and this will be a throw-in again for the Mariners. 20 minutes through in this first half. And Dillabaugh got pickpocketed on that, as that will go over into the VIU territory, and once again, it's Maya Creed. And they'll play it back out to Osborne. Dunlop to her far left, and here she is. Kara Dunlop. A searching pass, could not find Machida. And it goes back to Seneca. as they now will look to re-rack this possession, that is, and get their position moving forward. Played up ahead, and a crash of bodies, and a crash of bodies again, and now with his VIU, here they come, numbers in their favor, and into the 18 it goes, coming in, looking, shot, and a great save right there, Puma. Shea Batty with the shot. And Batty, who started six games, had 4 goals, 2 assists. And this will be a corner kick coming up here as Raven Edwards Dowdle came through on that sequence. So VIU gained their first real chance on net. And that almost got them the first goal off the foot of Shea Batty, who has 4 goals, 6, 2 assists to her name this season. Outswinger into the traffic of bodies over Dunlop. Ingram. Shot, the one hit, and going wide near side, Kinley. And this will be a goal kick for the Stingers as now VIU start to ask some questions of this Seneca back line. Ivery stolen. Here's Ingram with it. Trying to go to her left, and that will be taken away. Ivery was caught in two minds, and she almost had herself bamboozled as that was a play that almost created some Bambi on ice action from Ingram to Ivery. Dillaba. And now Seneca can't get this out of their own swampland that they've created. That shot going wide. And I'll race for it on the far side. This time it is. And they've been quality high end from her foot coming on that ball. And that's going to be launched into the night of Montreal. And now that opens up VIU. Here is Lamacchia with it. And that will be played into the 18. A missed kick right now. Could this be punished? Oh, and a tricky shot. Osborne had to hold that off not once but twice coming off the foot. Attacking prowess from both teams here. Some sublime passing from both teams here. And the finishing end product almost getting there for either side on getting the first goal here in this opening half of play. Lee. That's given away. And away come the Sting the other. That's ricochets off of the foot of Kinley. And this will be a Seneca throw-in. And this will go off of Kinley once more. And this will be a Seneca throw in part two. Played up quickly. Here come the Sting the other way. Long ball through. Taken away by VIU. Dunlop with it. Yamamoto to her far left. And she will now take a stroll upfield. Through ball. And oh my, she almost had a streaking Mazarenko, who was on second gear, and that ball was on fifth gear. As if Mazarenko had one more strength of energy in her, stride in her energy, that would have been in for a potential shot. Here's Mazarenko from distance, through ball coming in, on the far side it goes, shot, sharp angle, across the face of goal, out of play, and this will be a goal kick for the Stinger, for the Seneca Sting. After that shot coming in from Alfred, have not really shown much of a marauding presence with their attacking intent. Played up again. To the near side it comes. Here is Yamamoto. Recovered by Street. Dillaba. Dunlop. Creed going up ahead to Reynolds, streaking up, and that goes off the backside of Mazarenko, and played back into the traffic of bodies. And here comes Seneca the other way and tried to get that ball to Alfred, but Machida will win that race, will keep it alive. But right there is a member of the Seneca Sting that will safely put out of harm's way. And this will be a throw-in for the team from Nanaimo, BC. To get going. Now this could be it for them. Here they come down the near side. Alfred and Dunlop right there to take that away. Back over to Osborne. To the far side it comes. Played up ahead and in the air it goes. Played back down once more. Femeli. Diagonal pass. Finds a streaking Lamacchia. And now here is Street. 1v1 against Dunlop and a crash of bodies. Referee will let play continue on as Dunlop timed it perfectly and got that ball through. And now back with it is the Mariners. Machida. Centurion-like figure as Dunlop was able to marshal that ball away from harm's action. And now it will be a freaky. Play back out. Here's Dunlop, and she'll get that ball over. Take it away. Here is Alfred. Creed on air. That ball ricochets off of the ankle of Dunlop, and back over it comes to Seneca as they will let the ball roll through. That ball's popped up in the air. Alfred can't get to it. Play to the near side. Here comes Lamacchia. 1v1 against Yamamoto. And that will go out of play. Oh, and a sharp angle. As Osborne had to hold in far side post. But that will go out of play for a goal kick. NCAA Women's National Championships brought to you by Desjardins. And don't forget Derby Star, the official sponsor, the official soccer bar, the soccer ball of the CCAA National Championships. And 4imprint, the presenting sponsor of the Players of the Match here at the 2022 CCAA Women's National Championship presented by Desjardins from Seaway 3 on this day one of competition as it is now just past 5 or approaching 6. In fact, the VIU Mariners have had a history playing in the province of Quebec. Their men's basketball team won the 2013 Nationals at John Abbott. And it's for Seneca. They do have a history in Quebec themselves, as their men's basketball team won the Nationals at Montmorency in 2018. And now for the women's edition for soccer, they would like to win a national title here on the soil of Quebec. And back out it comes. Lamacchia. And that's ushered out by Dunlop for a throw-in for the Sting. Street. Give it away. Kinley. Popped up in the air. Played back over. Dillabaugh switching over now with Batty on the wing positions for the... And this will be a corner kick on the near side with 10 to go in this first half. Two in the six for the team in white. There's about 5 black shirts protecting that 6-yard box. Far post. Header. Ricochet. Loose ball over the nets. And this will go out of play for a goal kick for Seneca. Door and trying to get themselves that first goal. Play through, and this will be played out to Ingram. Osborne now at her feet. Out to Dunlop. And give it away. Street. Creed's got plenty of space to work with. She'll flex it back out to the wide side. And coming through is Reynolds. And losing it. And now here comes Sting on the counter. Long ball through. Here is Alfred. Down the left side she goes. And now with Dunlop on her. And this will go out of play for a throw-in. You can see now Seneca trying to free Alfred on the left flank. But VIU well aware with their radar on high alert for a top hitter like Alfred on the pitch. Half. Dunlop again. Batty. Tried to snake her way through the wall of black, but this met resistance. And this will go over the head, and this will be VIU possession on the throw-in. No question that the wear and tear of the turf has been on the Seneca side of the pitch in this first half, but it remains nil-nil. VIU cannot get themselves a chance of quality shot on net, and that won't help them as that ball goes off of, takes a ricochet again. Batty's pass. Play back out to the width, and here come the Mariners, and they will re-rack that possession on Dunlop's foot. Taken away, given away, and now to the near side it comes. Racing through and kept in by Pania, as she now will look to push it up when called upon. And they've been very influential. Batty. Can't get that through. Back to the near side it comes. Play through from Street. Well read by Reynolds. For the Seneca Sting. and the Sting. And backup comes over now for the Sting. Over the head, and now with it is Lamacchia, who will lose it out to excuse me, the throw in here for the Mariners. Long ball up ahead. Here is the running start coming through for the Mariners, and this will go out for a throw in. Dillabaugh cannot get that cleanly, and this will be a part two. But right now, the team in black might have given themselves a potential knockout blow with their early goal in this second half. Reynolds, diagonal ball through. This might have to open up the VIU Mariners to really take more chances here in this second half. That is launched up ahead. Played through and into the circle comes, and that will be cleaned up ahead. That is pushed out of way, back out to the near side it comes, and into the open area it goes. And that's well read by Dillabaugh. Here they come. It could be a 2v2. Dillabaugh streaking down the right flank, looking for options. He's got one open option now going through, and that's Abby Duncan. Dillabaugh dancing, well defended by Seneca. And here comes Sting the other way. And now you can feel the pace of this game pick up even more immensely. Pania coming through. Whistle offside Lamacchia. And this will stop play momentarily here. And you can just see now how both these teams broke down the door for the first goal, and now the edge nerves on the side of Team White trying to get themselves a priceless equalizer here in the second half. So Alfred scoring her goal 12 during the OCAA campaign, and she opens up her Nationals account with a goal. And now it is a 1-0 lead for the team in black against VIU. Alfred, a poacher of her status, definitely could have had that chance if she just did not ran out of runway pretty much in that situation. And here's a long ball through. This could be a tie game offside. As Batty went offside, she had two quality chances in the first half and able to come through in the second half on that situation. And this will be a free kick instead for the... And this will be launched into the South Shore nightlife, and back over it comes. Played through. Metcalf Simona in the game for the Sting. And now over to her right foot she goes. That's a nice first move from her. Foreign football team. The long distance shot. Oh, just missing the net target was Pania, who had five goals during the regular season. Nick Sting have really closed down the gaps. Played out to Kate Reynolds. That's forced up ahead, and that will go out of play, and Hoyt will usher it out as Dillabaugh is right there to take away that chance. And this will be a throw-in now for Reynolds on the near side. VIU's got about 33 minutes or so to figure out a tying goal. Now, if we are tied at 90, we go to PK direct. This game brought to you by Johnson's, the official championship award ring provider of the CCAA, and presenting sponsor. Yamamoto's pass back out to Creed. Reynolds. And that is cleared up and cleaned up by the Seneca Sting. And this will be launched up ahead as it goes back to Osborne, who's now well off for crease line, as VIU will have less than a half an hour to figure out some sort of option to get themselves a potential tying goal here from Seaway 3. That ball going by Jordan Burke and back over to Iaveri. Iaveri had a crucial touch of deflection to make this, to prevent it from being 1-0 for VIU in the first half. As you see right now, the scoreline is 1-0 for Seneca. And this will go out of play for a throw-in for the Mariners. Yamamoto will take it. And now you can start seeing the VIU water tie starting to push forward here, trying to get themselves that tying goal. Duncan splits through, falling over. Play on, referee says. And now into the box, and that goes wide on the far side. And this will be a goal kick here for the Seneca Sting. Could the Sting find an insurance policy with less than half an hour to go in this second half? Headed back down. Hoyt. That ball deflects through. Alfred can get to it off the ricochet of Femeli, and now back with it is the VIU Mariners, and that's well defended by Iaveri and played back out. All by himself is Alfred, trying to get around the one-touch pass to Kinley. Looping one up ahead and played back over. That's going to be ricocheted up into the VIU territory. Racing down there is Seneca's own Metcalf-Simona. And this is given away. Duncan. Here's a Kobe's chance. Reynolds. Again, everyone behind the ball for, who had 7 goals, 3 assists during the regular season. And this will be a free kick for the VIU Mariners in the 64th minute of play. On this long free kick. Duncan. Deflection. And right into the keeper's hands it goes. As Seneca now will look to take their time and kind of put a vice grip. Given away, back over to the Mariners. And here is Kobe finding Dillabaugh in a 1v1. Going to her left against Hoyt. And this will be played back out. Near side comes. And taking the caught in two minds theory is Reynolds, who looked up. And now the VIU Mariners will make a substitution. And Hannah Rose will come in the game for the Mariners. Present, here she is, really starting to pick up the rhythm, really starting to become a menace against that back four of VIU. Dillabaugh back with it, going to the right side. Dillabaugh dancing to see the heavyweights really start throwing some blows in this matchup here. And now, could this body blow from Abby Duncan, and also being pressured by a player who's brought the injection and pace in Lamacchia. And this will be a throw-in coming up for Hoyt. Duncan. And a crash of bodies this time back out. Hoyt with it. Back over to Iaveri. And then we'll go to the far side, played up ahead. Here is Udenberg. Metcalf-Simona back to Udenberg. Udenberg again. Finding her way through to a Seneca player. Here comes Alfred, who's been the backbone, has been the link-up so far for the play up ahead. And back with it is the Mariners. Dillabaugh on the right side. Her first touch was too heavy. Okabe gets it back. Reynolds. to the wide side. And Alfred is a little bit slow right now. She might have pulled up lame, and you can see she's walking and unable to get the speed required. And she's at the center circle right now, and back to Osborne's feet it goes. And now she goes down on her legs. It appears she might have pulled up with a cramp. And they were for the remainder of this game, if not for tomorrow, if they do advance to the Final Four of the gold medal bracket. Championships. Huddle, the official CCAA film exchange partner of the CCAA, and Canada Soccer, the national sport organization partner of the CCAA. Championships. And this game, or this tournament, also presented by Desjardins for the 2022 CCAA National Women's Tournament here from Saint-Lambert, Quebec. As it appears now for Alfred that she might have run her race for the day. It wasn't a good news situation for them moving ahead here. And now, what will Seneca's game plan be without the link-up of Alfred? Will they be playing with a little bit more caution? As for VIU, they need to abandon the caution element here and get themselves moving forward, because they will have to take some risk in the final 20 of this matchup. Long ball from Dunlop. Played over the head and back in, and a crash of bodies play on into the six to go. Tory, and back over comes to Creed. Here is Rose. Reynolds. Putting one up ahead, open space. Pierce batting the final third. And again, well read by Seneca's back line. And this, who's going to blink first? Dunlop, Osborne. Dunlop again from Nanaimo, BC. Ingram's pass. Yamamoto's pass. Goes right over to Pania. Both teams full of big hitters this year. The number one goal scoring team in the OCAA was Seneca with 50. Gutenberg, and this will go towards the end line, and Batty's slow to get up, as she might be hurt even more, her left ankle. And this may not be good news for VIU to lose one of their top speed players on this team here. And Udenberg seen how she was doing, but for Batty right now, it could be a pulled muscle cramp. Hopefully that is the case. Off the shores of the St. Lawrence River. So when you add in the river as well, that cold breeze coming off the waterfront makes it a little bit more chillier, and those tackles a little bit more crunchier. Here, the 2022 CCAA Women's National Championship brought to you by Desjardins. And don't forget, after we're done here, flip over to the men's edition happening at Langara College in lovely British Columbia. And it looks like Batty's going to be okay, which is good news for the VIU Mariners. So the loser of this game will play tomorrow at high noon, as they will face Mount St. Vincent. And if Seneca are to hold on, they will have a date with Ahuntsic tomorrow at this time, a 5:30 kickoff. Now become an essence for the Mariners. Rose. Dunlop. And that's given away. And here comes the Sting the other way, trying to buzz one more ring if they can get a second goal to add to the gloss of that lead. And that will go into the hands of Osborne. A second goal will be more than an insurance policy. It would give them a passport to victory and a date with the Hudsuck next or tomorrow night, that is. Here is Duncan. Back out to Batty, and this will go out for a throw-in for VIU. Whistle, sub. And now coming in the game for VIU is Machida, and going off will be Batty. So Shea Batty has run her race, and she's not too happy about that. I think that she might have had another 15 minutes left in herself to get that potential tying goal. He fired away this time by Lee. Streets pass. Takes a bounce. Back in favor of VIU. Dunlop. Dillabaugh. Dillabaugh dancing against Hoyt. They've been going at it all game long as Hoyt has babysat Dillabaugh wherever she's gone. And now giveaway. Here comes Street. And that's going to be closed down and recovered off the hash for a moment by Creed. And right into the feet it goes to Creed. Dunlop playing to the far side. Here is Yamamoto. Creed with it. Now it's a question of parking the bus perhaps for Seneca and just playing out this game. Mentality Monsters is probably the definition they will use in trying to close out this game against VIU. They will require another 10 more minutes of concentration plus added time. And here's one who can definitely finish this game off. Is Lamacchia, and this went out of play, and this will be a throw-in for, or offside that is, for, or now this will be a throw-in. It looked like it was the case to be initially, and not an offside, and with it is Creed. Dunlop. Play through deflection, loose ball. Hoyt's really been influential in the second half with her defending for Seneca. That's played off the ricochet, double bounce, triple bounce, and over it comes to Metcalf Simona. Open space now, coming down the left side. Here's Lamacchia in the final third, closed down this time by a lovely move to the far corner, off the crossbar, the edge of the envelope, rattled by the foot of Lamacchia, who had 9 goals during the regular season, and that goal could have been the passport to victory, perhaps. And Osborne was caught looking like a tourist on that. And here is Lamacchia again. Looking this way, that away, going for a goal. Ambitious shot, and that goes wide to left this time. As Lamacchia really looking like a stardust player with a quick silver step to her feet that she has. 9 to go in this game. Is there one more goal to be had by VIU? Can they go into their Nanaimo bag of tricks and get themselves that potential tying goal, which would be priceless in the hopes of keeping the national conversation alive for them and force PKs? Down to the near side it comes. And protecting the ball with all her will is Udenberg. And this will go back to Seneca the other way. Played through, and this will go out of bounds for a throw-in for Seneca. And it will be Udenberg who will take it on the near side. Again, no hurry at all to get this ball back to play. And that went over the head, and this will be over Pania's head off the last touch of Creed. Udenberg, part two. Street. And this will go out again. A third header, or third throw-in, I beg your pardon, coming in for Seneca. Udenberg once more. Unaberg again, looking for that throw in once more. That's played through, and now with it, Street can't get that shot on net. That's blocked by Dunlop. Back out it comes, over to the near side it comes. Unaberg getting knocked over, and the referee will blow the whistle. This will be a free kick coming up here for Seneca. As Unaberg will feel that tomorrow morning as they get ready for their second game, whether it's at high noon or at 5:30 tomorrow night. Free kick for Jordan Burke. Burke, 2 goals to her name this year. Played in 10, started in 7, and there's 7 to go in this game before the 90 hits. And it goes over everyone's head who was last touched by. This will be a Seneca corner kick. And again, the Sting will take their time. A leisure walk towards the far corner, knowing that they have this game at their mercy. Famale will be the one who will take this corner kick. If they can add a little bit more gloss to this one-goal lead, 2 goals might be more than enough to punch their ticket with a date against the Hudson Eagles. In swinger. Header! They got it! This can be the passport to victory for Seneca. And they're up by 2 with 6 to go. A beautiful finish. And that could end VIU's hopes of a national title here from Saint-Lambert, Quebec. A perfect second half. A dynamic second half. And now a date awaits with the Hudsik tomorrow at 5:30 p.m. And for VIU, their hopes for a national title looking like they are on life support now here in this second half. Seneca getting the insurance policy that they needed. And now looking to close out this game here with less than 5 to go. Lamacchia with the goal. And now a chance to keep their hopes alive for a national title. They finished up as the runner-up. They finished as the runner-up in the OCAA, losing to Humber College. This is a Sting team that went 10-0 during the regular season. They won their division by 8 points, had 50 goals for it, won against the entire year. 9 clean sheets. 5 times they scored 5-plus goals in the game, including twice they scored 10 in the game. 9 players had 2-plus goals this year. And now, here they are, 4 and change away from a semifinal date against a Hudsik. And for VIU, a tale of two halves. The first half, they were in control of the narrative. Second half, an early goal unraveled that narrative, and now a late goal has extinguished their flame of hope in trying to get themselves into that discussion of a tie game and PKs. Played right through and right into the hands of Osborne. And for the VIU players who were on the 2019 team that won a silver medal, their hopes of gold and silver are all but done, and now they will look to aim to win a bronze in the next couple of days. Hannah Rose with it. That's deflected through, and good news for Seneca, as back on the pitch is Shanice Alfred, and trying to work their way through on the near side. This will go out for a throw-in. Less than 3 to go in this matchup. And a sub coming in for VIU as Narduzzi will come back in. And going out is Courtney Ingram. Unterberg not rushing the play yet. And this will go out for another throw in for the Seneca Sting. Again, for Seneca, this is a team that has yet to win a national championship. And that ball will go into the last row of the stands here. And played back out at a play. It will be for a throw in once more. And you can just see the air let out for VIU, knowing that their aspirations for a national title has been done up by that goal from Lamacchia in the second half. And this will be a free kick here for the Seneca Sting. Nice seconds away from the 90. Two-person wall for the VIU Mariners. And right now, it is probably damage limitations to make sure this doesn't get out of hand to a three-goal victory if they do convert here for Seneca. Alfred. To the far post it goes. And this will be played out of harm's way. Still going back and forth of the one hits. And over it comes. And now into it comes. And here is Alfred once more. And this will be played back into the box and into the Osborne hands as we are now 40 seconds away from the 90. Alfred. Pania. And this will go out into the last third. Osborne off for a line as they look to have a little bit a last roll of the dice here in this game. Dunlop coming through to the far side it goes. Yamamoto's pass finds Dilaba. And here is Dilaba coming through around not one but two. Trying to work around three. Now there's a wall of black around her. 3 minutes left in added time here from Seaway 3. Could we see an ultimate smash and grab for VIU? They need to score two more in the less than three. But by the looks of the arrow pointing towards the team in black, that might come at a high odds. Creed. That shot takes a off hit right there on the shank and played back out. Here's Dunlop. Played back in. Into the box it goes. And a well-played defending by the keeper for Seneca to take that away. Darian Ryan comes in the game, one goal, two assists, started four games, played in nine this year. As Seneca using their allotment of subs, knowing that they have this game in the bag now with a 2-0 lead. Creed. And here's a player that was a star that no one's going to talk about, Corny Iavari, who made a massive intervention to prevent the opening goal for VIU. And with about a minute 40 left here in this ball game, that Iavari play might come back. And if they end up winning the Nationals, that could be the reason why they did. Played back out to the final third. Creed's pass, and this will go right into the keeper's hands. And no hurry at all to get this game back underway as we are down to the final 80 seconds left before this game expires on VIU. Here's Lamacchia. And this goes out. And this will be a VIU throw-in. Or goal free kick, that is a big part of the offside from Alfred. Alfred. About 40 seconds left in this game. And this goes right by Udenberg and Creed. And back over to the keeper it comes. Last roll of dice for VIU. Creed. Across the face of goal. Deflected off of Dillenberg. Shot. And that is wide left. And that will be it for VIU. Seneca on their way to a date with Ahuntsic. VIU will clash with Mount St. Vincent in an East Coast, West Coast battle. And that is it here. Seneca win 2-0 over VIU. And now we have day two set. Champlain will take on Humber in an OCAA versus RCQ battle. And Seneca will take on Ahuntsic in another RCQ OCAA. And in the early morning games tomorrow morning, it'll be Red Deer against St. Boniface. And it'll be VIU against Mount St. Vincent tomorrow in the morning session on day two here from Seaway 3. Up next now, the player of the game. And that'll be it here from Seaway. So stay tuned for the player of the game presentation. And then we'll see you tomorrow for day two of action. 2-0 lead, 2-0 win for Seneca over VIU. And you can see the pain in VIU's huddle, knowing that they were in control of the game for the most part, and unfortunately came up short at the beginning and end of the second half. And now the player of the game introduction, player of the games here for VIU and Seneca coming up as both teams do the handshake line just at the outside of the lip of the circle. Dunlop having a great game today. Unfortunately, that wasn't enough for VIU to keep their hopes alive.
And from Seneca, number four, Olivia Lamacchia.
And there you have it, the player of the games. So, Seneca wins 2-0 over VIU, and that will complete day one of competition here from Seaway 3. The 2022 Women's National Championships brought to you by Desjardins. We'll see you tomorrow at 10 o'clock for St. Boniface against Red Deer, and for day two competition here from Seaway 3. On behalf of the staff and crew, wish you a good evening, and turn over to the men's side at Langara College for the remainder of day one of the men's nationals out of British Columbia. We'll see you tomorrow morning at 10 a.m. Bye for now.
After that, we have at 12:30, MSU taking on VIU. And then at 3 p.m., Humber Hawks taking on the host, Champlain Cavaliers. And finally, Dan up to